Welcome. This is Felicia Renee, and you are watching and tuning in to A Vintage Love with Influent Media Radio. Today, we have Tron Moses in the house. Who is Tron? Who is Tron? Well, if you stay tuned, you're going to find out. So I'm so excited. We're going to groove to some music and just get into the perfect place and have a perfect vibe so that the Lord can come in and do a mighty work within each and every person that is watching and tuned in. So thank you and Happy New Year. I'm still celebrating because I know the Lord has some great and amazing things in store for us this year. So stay tuned. Share, invite your friends, invite your followers, copy the link and share. Thank you. Hey guys, let me know who you are. Comment. Let me know where you're coming from, where you're from. Let me know who you are. Say hello and let me know where you're tuning in from.
Get the actors off stage. tricks begin. Do you want a revolution? You want to hear new songs? God is cleaning up house. And mercy started right at home. I'm a miracle one. Some money and fame. Everybody got a title, but do you know your name? If we humble ourselves, people fall on our face and ask God everything in me that's not right, take it away.
Even that joy that I can't explain, an extra piece out of me is a pain. I want that love that'll never change. Give me that.
Patron, if you're here, comment for me. Hey guys, again, this is Felicia Renee with A Vintage Love on Influent Media Radio. And we are so excited because we have Tron Moses here. And he's here, and so I'm going to add him in, and we're going to get started. I'm going to pray us in, and let me invite him, and then we're going to get started. Thank you today for allowing us to come and to give you glory today, Father. And you thought it not robbery, Father, to allow this platform, Father God, so that your people could give you glory, Father. So today, myself and everyone else joining in with Tron, Father God, we are giving you glory. We are lifting your name on high, Father God, and we are your heavenly name. We are giving you glory. So we just thank you, Father. We thank you, Father, Father God, for the things that you have prepared for us, Father God, because everything that you have prepared for us gives you glory, Father God, and it is to uplift your kingdom, Father. So we thank you, Father, for loving us the way that you do. We thank you, Father, for only you can do for us. And we thank you, Father God, for loving us, Father, and showing us perfect example, Father, the way you do each and every day, Father. We thank you, Father God, that you show us, Father God, that the only one that we need to lean and depend on is you, Father God. And if we try to lean and depend on someone else, Father God, like you have intended for us to lean and depend on you, we will be disappointed every time, Father. So we just give you glory, and we give you praise, and we give you thanks, Father God, that we can lean and depend on you, Father God. Never fail. You will never fail, and you will always come for us, Father God, and you will not leave nor forsake us, Father God, and even the bad, Father God. For the ones that love you, Father God, you will turn those bad things around for the good of those who love you, Father. And we just thank you. So I thank you, Father, that you've already gone before us, Father God, before the show even began, Father God, and you have made provisions for us, Father God. And I thank you, Father, for you right now. And I thank you, Father, for what you are doing on this show today of Vintage Love. In your name we pray, amen, 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 amen. Hi, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Thank you. So I'm just really excited that you are here. I just want to thank you for being here. And I want you to tell us a little bit. I'm going to tell a little bit, you know, about you as well and how I came to know you. But I just want you to tell us a little bit about who you are and what you do, and then we'll get into the interview.
All right. Well, I'm Tron Moses. I'm originally from Brooklyn, New York. I'm living in South Carolina now. Originally from Brooklyn, New York. Matter of fact, I want to plug this real quick. I have a book out called "Who Touched Me," and it's my full testimony. And I'm originally from Brooklyn, New York, and I've been living here for about since 97, gave my life to the Lord in 1994. I backslid after 4 months, and I stayed out there from 94 until 2004. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't regret it, because from 94 to 2004, I stayed out there long enough to know that I never wanna go back.
Hallelujah.
And right now, amen. And right now, what I do is, I do photography. I mess with videos. I do the video archiving on YouTube, which most people would know the name Tron Moses from.
Yes. And so I'm going to stop you just for a minute right there, and I'm going to let everybody know how I know you. And so we just had like a 2-year anniversary, okay? And so when the Lord placed it on my heart to reach out to you and ask you if you would be
on the show, it was like it all came together right then. Like, that is why you added him as a friend, because this is a year, I believe, that, you know, the Lord is going to make those names great. Like, he's choosing people and he's going to make their names great. And that's the perfect example. He used you, you know. Of course, you know, God used Jesus, you know, his name is great in the earth, but there was an example that he can use someone from just a regular background, or a regular everyday Joe or Jenny, and he can use that person to edify and uplift the kingdom like he did you. Because I didn't know who you were. There were a lot of people that didn't know who you were, but when Apostle John or Alexis Mastin or Sophia Ruffin or Matthew Stevenson would say your names, you know, they have a lot of followers at the time a few years ago when I started to follow them. And so this is how it happened, guys. So on Periscope, when Periscope became big a few years ago, Periscope only gave you 24 hours to watch a video, okay? So if you don't catch the live, or if you don't catch it within that 24 hours, it erased and deleted.
It was gone.
And so now all you have is hearsay. Yeah, you know, you didn't hear that word that Apostle John gave, and, you know, you didn't hear this teaching that, you know, Sophia Ruffin or Matthew Stevenson gave. You know, it's like, no, I missed it. Dang. So then this is where Tron came. This is where Tron came on the map. Now, he's been on the map now. Like, you know, God knew about him. He made him. He gave him his name, gave him a new name. But when everyone else knew you, it was, okay, well, there's a guy. You know, even Apostle Eckhart and all the other ones, well, we didn't know. We don't know this guy, but there's a guy named Tron Moses, and he's taking and archiving all of my old videos. So go to YouTube and follow Tron. And I was like, yeah, you know, so that's the first thing I did. Like, when he got off of Periscope, I would go on YouTube, and I found you, and I followed you, and I was like, yes, I'm going to follow this man. So because the words that I have kids. So I wasn't able, every time my phone would ding from Periscope, I couldn't jump on there every time. So, you know, when they said your name and they said who you were, and this happened not only for me, but for other followers and other believers of these big names in ministry and in the kingdom. And so,
Some of them haven't heard the name Tron Moses until people said in the comments, I found out about you from Tron Moses.
Yes. And so it went the other way. So it worked both ways. Either we heard from the big names, or it was people who were following you or had worked with you previously that heard about, you know, some of the ones that you, the videos that you were posting on your YouTube. So I just want to kind of talk about that today. I want to ask you a few questions about the way that God moved with you on that. How did God come to you and say, Tron, I want you to archive and put the videos of the leaders on YouTube so that they can have access? How did you come about doing that?
Okay, well, the only reason the channel is named Tron Moses, because it was a photography channel. Okay. I had three videos on there of me doing photo shoots.
Uh-huh.
And after a while, I figured, you know, I'm going to make these videos private. I made the videos private, and I didn't use the channel for a while. But if I would have started out doing videos, I probably would have named the channel something else.
Okay.
But since it was my photography channel, I named it Tron Moses. And let me see. I posted a video of a guy here named, he's well known here. His name is Bishop Michael Blue. Okay. I posted a video of him on TBN. I posted a couple of Karn videos that I recorded from him live streaming somewhere. And then people started following me. And then the videos was getting so much. I had like two or three of his videos. The videos getting so much likes and so many people started following me, I decided to continue on and start getting all of his stuff. Then when Periscope came along, I was watching a few people, and then I decided, you know what? I'm gonna start getting these people videos too. And even today, a lot of people don't have Periscope.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have Periscope, so they see stuff when it come on YouTube.
Right.
And even some people that have Periscope, some people just go watch it on YouTube. I guess because like the buffering sometimes and
yes.
So a lot of people just watch it when it get on YouTube.
Okay, so it started with a well-known pastor from where you're from, right? So yes, that's how it started. So you started to post his videos. You got a lot of likes and you got a lot of
people. No, I only posted one of his videos.
Oh, you only posted
when he was.
Okay, so you only posted one, but you had three of your own from the photography, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and so you decided, okay, well, you know, I got a lot of likes on this one. You know, these Periscope ones, they disappearing. You know, they doing a disappearing act on us. You know, so everybody can't get the word that the Lord has given because it's disappearing so fast, and there's no way to get it back. And so you decided that you were going to take those videos and place them on YouTube. And you're right. You know, a lot of people don't have Periscope. I have to be honest. Because Periscope and Twitter are connected, right? They're connected. Yeah. I've been a part of Twitter probably since it's been a thing. And I really don't get it yet. I have to be honest. So the only reason, like, I really use my Twitter and my name is because of Periscope. And so, you know, there's people that don't get on Periscope and there's people that don't get on Twitter. So you were the avenue that God used on YouTube because there's millions and billions of users for YouTube. So you were that go through. You were that avenue that they took to get the word of the Lord out. And like I said, it's so many people on YouTube. And so when they were seeing that you are posting Apostle John, they may have never even heard of Apostle John. I didn't even know about Apostle John until I'm in Kentucky. So, you know, I had no idea. But when I got on Periscope and I started to follow certain people, you know, then you can share their videos. And so when people started to share, then that's how I found out about Apostle John. And then he would shout out Alexis Mastin. And then he would shout out Sophia Ruffin. And that's how, you know, it's just like the Lord started to open up these avenues, you know, through Apostle John and different things like that. So it's almost like every time I would hear Apostle John say, you know, go check Tron Moses out, go check, you know, this one out, then I would go and check him out because, you know, he became a prevalent voice in my life at that time because, you know, I was going to a church, but it was a church that wasn't really feeding me. You know, I was for the more of God at that moment. And so I was spending a lot of time on YouTube and on Periscope. And so, you know, what you did really changed a lot of people's lives because, you know, they may have been brought up or you know, maybe the church that they did attend was a traditional Baptist or a traditional.
And a lot of people have said that.
Yeah.
A lot of people have said that in a certain video. They'd be like, I'm not getting this at my church.
Yes.
So people was hungry for that.
Yes.
People was hungry for that.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Now look, you say you in Kentucky now. Y'all do have Christian bookstores, right?
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, we do.
Come on, the name John Eckhart been around for years. Like, I never seen his face. When I would go to the bookstore, I would always see John Eckhart and see like two names I would always see with a bunch of books in the bookstore: John Eckhart and Francis Fingerpaint.
Mm-hmm.
I would always see those names, and Eckhart done been on. He been on Benny Hinn. This one, Eckhart had a little weight on him.
Yes,
Eckhart, see that. Been on Benny Hinn. Yeah, it done been on. Yeah. He's been around for a long time.
He has. Yeah. And it's funny because when I started to follow him, I went to Bargain Books. You know, Bargain Books. You heard of Bargain Books?
I think so.
Okay. Well, I went to Bargain Books and I was like, you know what? You know, he's talking about all these books he's written. I'm about to go and find me a book so I can, you know, I can read a John Eckhart book. And I went in there and I was amazed. I was like, wow, where have I been? And like I said, I was in a traditional Baptist. So, you know, when you're in a traditional Baptist, you listening to what that man said and all of the guests and the guest pastors and preachers that you have in your afternoon service. Okay, I'm just being real. I'm just being real. So, you know, like you said, people hunger and they want more. And I just believe that this is the season of entrepreneurship. This is the season where God is pushing us out of our box. He's saying it's time to get out of your comfortable space and move to the space that may be a little uncomfortable for a while, but you're not going to be able to get to the place that I'm trying to take you unless you try to step out, unless you step out and you do something that you've never done before. Because in this season, I am trying to do a new thing. So you can't stay in that old place. You got to move to the new place that I'm pushing you towards. And so the reason that I've decided to, you know, the Lord placed it on my heart to reach out to you is because I feel like in that moment, you are doing a new thing. You are doing something different. You are doing a new thing. And you trusted God enough to say, okay, God, I'm going to post these people's videos. You know, they might get mad at me. They might say something. But, you know, I'm doing this for your people. You know, I'm doing this for your people and your glory and your wife. Hi, wifey. She said, trying is the kingdom of entrepreneurship. So I knew that the Lord was not straying me, you know, leading me astray by asking you to come on the show. Because like I said, I feel like this is the year of entrepreneurship. Believe it or not.
You know what? It's funny that you said that some people might like it, some people don't, because that's the truth. Like, some people over this, since I've been doing it, some people want to be on the channel.
Yeah.
Some people don't. I respect that. Yeah. People have came to me to be on the channel. People have sent people to me. Matter of fact, that's how the thing started with Eckhart. Mm-hmm. He sent Alexis to me to get certain videos.
Uh-huh.
And other people have came to me, and then there was people that came and they didn't want their videos on the channel. And I respected that. I said, okay, I'll take it down.
Right. But you still did.
It go both ways.
You could have been both ways, but you didn't let it stop you. The thought of them not agreeing with it didn't let it stop you, because you're a man of God. So if someone feels a certain way about something and they come to you, like the Bible says, you know, they lay their gifts down, they come to you and they, you know, they tell you what's on their mind. Then of course, like, okay, well, yeah, I'll take it off or whatever. But you are allowing them a platform to have the word of the Lord heard. So you were doing your due diligence. And that is all that matters. And that is all that God asks us to do. Do what I ask you to do. Be obedient. And you are obedient. Amen.
Because the way I always saw it, like, even though I'm not the one preaching, I was sharing the gospel.
Yes.
With all these preachers, I was sharing the gospel. Yeah.
Yes. And you are a minister. You're a minister of God. And your wife is a minister and a prophet of God. And her ministry is Kimberly Moses Ministries, right?
Right.
Kimberly Moses right. Ministry, shout out. Yes. So go in and check Tron out. And, you know, When I was following your channel, when I came to follow your channel, and, you know, that makes us want to know who you are. You know, I wanted to know who you were. How did you just pop up on the scene like that? You know,
and that was weird for me. That was weird for me.
Yeah.
To be honest with you, that was weird for me. Because you even see my reaction. I'm like, why would y'all want me?
Right.
You know, because, like, let me tell you, when I went to Texas and Alexis had a, last year, Alexis had a conference.
You was there. I was there too. Reset. Was it?
No, no.
It was different.
No, the year before, Generals of Deliverance, the year before, 2016.
Okay.
And Eckhart, Sophia Ruffin, and some other people was there. And, you know, I was doing the pictures. Uh-huh. So I had my name on my shirt. A lot of people might not have known the face, but they knew the name. And so me and two other people were walking, and this girl said, Tom Moses. And that shocked me. It's kind of weird for me because, like, I never did this to be recognized. And right. I told you the only reason my name is on the channel is because it was a photography channel. Now, if I started this doing videos, I would have named it something else. Because, like, you see, most people that video archive is on YouTube, their channel is not their name. They mm-hmm. named it something else. Mm-hmm. And that's probably what I would have went with.
Well, you
but
know,
I feel like it was the will of the Lord.
It was. It definitely was. I'm telling you, because, and that's another thing I want to talk about. I want to talk about how you know, the YouTube channel impacted your business. How did that impact your business? Because, you know, when I was thinking about, it's like when the Lord placed you on my heart, and I was just thinking about how, you know, everything went, like how fast everything went, because it was like a flood. Everything went so quickly. Like, your name was put out in the earth and it just went like a blazing fire. And I just wondered, you know, I was like, Lord, how did that look for him? How did that feel for him? That everything took off the way that it did. And everybody was talking about Tron Moses, you know, and then he has, you know, you had your video blogs, your vlogs and you know, your photography business and your ministering and, you know, just everything else that you were doing. So I just wanted to know, like, tell us how that looked. How did that look like? How did that feel? Like, what type, because I know it was a process. So what was the process like that the Lord was taking you through, because he made your name great in this earth?
The channel, to me, it seemed like the channel just, it took off. And I look at the numbers, and then it got to the point where that there would be like 1,000 subscribers a month, and it just blew my mind, because I didn't expect that. Mm-hmm. I saw it as me just sharing the bishop here and me sharing a few of Khan videos. Like I told you, people subscribing now, liking the videos is one thing, watching the videos is one thing, but people subscribing, I didn't expect that.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't expect to have 2,000 subscribers.
Right.
I didn't expect to have 6,000 subscribers. then 10,000. That really blew my mind. 10,000 subscribers. Now, even though they wasn't there for me,
right?
But I didn't expect it.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't expect it. And now before this month is over, it will be at 40,000.
Wow, that is. And you see, like, God will do a mighty and a quick work in our lives. Like, you know, especially if you're working and you're worshiping him in spirit and in truth, and you're doing everything from a pure heart, which you were. You know, there are a lot of people that are in ministry that are doing things for gain, and they're not doing, you know, they're not going about it with a pure heart, but you did everything from a pure heart, you know. And it's just like, you know, I didn't want my name to be known. Like, I was just doing it, you know, to, because I know that people needed to hear the word. You know, I know that people needed to hear the word of God. I know people wanted the more of God. And so that's why I did it. And that is what the Lord is looking for. And that is who he's looking to promote in this season. You know, he's starting to demote the people who are doing things from the wrong motives. But the ones who have pure hearts, he is promoting the pure hearts and the ones who worship in spirit and in truth in this season. And you didn't ask for it, and he gave you a promotion. So go forth and tell us about how it impacted your other businesses, your vlogs, and how, you know, the Lord started to release, because I feel this in my spirit right now, how the Lord started to release the visions and the dreams that you're moving forward and forth in right now, your books and, you know, just everything that you have a hand in right now?
Well, the growth of this channel made me want to do other YouTube channels. Because let's be honest, YouTube is a business.
Oh, yeah.
It's a business. And right now, the vlog channel, we're trying to grow the vlog channel. And we understand that everybody don't watch vlogs.
Right.
I didn't watch vlogs until this girl I know, she got married. And then I seen them posting videos on YouTube, Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how I started watching vlogs. So I understand everybody in the kingdom, I say, is not into vlogs.
Right.
But I think the vlogs are beautiful.
I do.
It's just showing us, it's nothing fancy in it. It's just showing us living our lives, talking about regular days, having fun. We take you on dates. We take you in the kitchen. We just enjoying our lives.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, that's called Team Moses Vlogs for y'all.
Moses Vlogs. Everybody check that out. His wife is a beautiful woman of God. And I think that's really important, you know, because everybody's, we are not of the world. We are in the world, but we're not of the world. But it's so many people that look at what they see on TV, like all this reality TV and all this mess, okay? And so they look and they feel like, okay, well, everybody's not what they post to be, okay? So it's good to see a kingdom couple, a kingdom marriage that is thriving and that is doing well. And you don't have to be fake about anything that's going on, you know? Yes, we're human. Yes, you know, we have, you know, things going on, but we love God. At the end of the day, we love God and we keep him first. And that is why we're able to thrive. And that is why our marriage is blessed. Amen.
That's right. And we started it to like show him the process.
Mm-hmm.
When she was living, the vlogs actually started when she was living in Colorado.
Okay. Uh-huh.
And she started recording them then. And then after a while, I said to her, you know what? After you record every video, send it to me, let me edit it, then we put it on YouTube. Because she was just putting it straight on YouTube.
Uh-huh.
I said, let me edit, then we put it on YouTube. Then when she moved here, she was living in North Carolina, and we still recording. So you see the process. Then we take you house hunting. And that video got a lot of views. You see the process. And then the day we got married, we came and told the people that too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That is amazing. That's amazing. So since you started your vlogs, and we haven't gotten to the photography, but since you started your vlogs, how has your business expanded since all of this exposure?
I'm sorry, say that again.
How has your business expanded? You know, how has the Lord blessed your business and expanded your business since all of this exposure? Like, how did, you know, things transform? So, because I know when you started to get all the followers, just like me, you know, I didn't know who you were and I wanted to know who you were, you know, regardless of if you were posting about somebody that I knew and I had been following for a while, but I wanted to know who Tron Moses was. I wanted to know who is Tron Moses. So I came and found you on Facebook. I added you. You know, I was looking at all the beautiful portraits you had posted. And I even seen your wife just said open doors. Amen. Yes. And so, you know, I went to your page and I saw all the beautiful portraits that you had taken, and I actually used the model. And so I was just like, wow, that is beautiful. I wish he was in my area because I would hit him up for a shoot, you know, to do my maternity shoot and, you know, different things like that. So it's like,
well, put me on a plane. Put me on a plane, I think.
Well, that was almost 2 years ago, but I was thinking that, you know, I was like, man, you know, I really wish that I could work with you. And then I saw a post that you posted yesterday and you were talking about how people were saying that you needed to take down your older pictures because of improvement. And you were like, no, you know, because that shows how I have improved. Like, that shows my journey. And that's just the same with us. Yeah. Like you said, you were 1994, you backslid and you didn't come back until when?
2004.
And you said you wouldn't trade that for the world. And you know, there's so many lessons that the Lord shows us. He shows us. He teaches us things, you know, through the process. And I think that that is very profound that you would say that. And you know, and it's crazy to me that the person who, or the people, and, you know, we won't, you know, say any names or anything like that, but they wouldn't realize or understand that that is just showing me how far God has brought me. You know?
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Well, as far as the photography business, I'm really still trying to get it to where I want it. Like, we just recently moved because I'm from a small town.
Okay.
And not to knock them, but, you know, like, when people kind of familiar with you, they feel like comfortable with you, mm-hmm. they'd rather give somebody else that money.
I already know
where you're going. And I'm gonna be honest with you. And like I said, this is not to knock them, but the town I came from, I feel like they don't understand quality.
Mm-hmm.
They don't understand it. Like, people in other places, like you said, they wish I was near them.
Yeah.
But the town I come from, the town I came from, they don't understand quality. Because I've seen, they'll go to somebody who pictures look like it was taken with cell phones.
Yeah.
Before they come to me. Yeah. And let me tell you, when my price was only $100, it got back to me that people were saying, I'm charging too much. If you get the same quality in New York or Atlanta, that's about $600.
Right.
$100 is not, if you work at minimum wage, you could afford me.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the town I came from. They didn't appreciate it.
Oh yeah. I know about a small town because I too am from a small town. And you know, they didn't receive Jesus. And what did he do? He dusted his sandals off and kept moving. So dust yourself off.
But you know, it's a blessing too, because it'll cause you to launch out into the deep.
Yes.
And launch out into other places.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because the disciples, when Jesus told them to go into all the world, they stayed right there into Jerusalem until persecution came. Persecution is what pushed them to other places. Mm-hmm. Now, I wasn't persecuted, but the fact that a lack of business in my town and people not understanding quality and what I'm putting into it, because I feel like my photo shoot is a production. If you've seen what I take the photo shoots, you understand that I can't charge you $30, $40, $50 right. for a photo shoot.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't leave my house for that. If you want to give me $40, and I just take a pit snapshot of you in my yard. But come on, if I'm bringing all of this and then I'm taking time, I edit every photo.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you model, you know, most photographers, they're not editing every photo. Most photographers will edit 3 photos mm-hmm. and charge you for anything extra to be edited.
Yes.
I edit every photo because I care about my work. And some people will put that, they'll put those pictures out there unedited, and I want my work to look the best when it's out there.
Mm-hmm.
So I can't just give you a photo shoot for $30, $40.
That's right. And you pay for what you get. And everything right. that and Kimberly said, he works hard. And you can tell you work really hard. Just by, I mean, every photo that I have looked at and I have viewed, it looks like it comes straight from a magazine. Everyone.
Thank you.
Straight from a magazine. I'm just like, oh, he makes me want to come out of retirement. For real.
Come on now.
Yes.
Come out.
Yes. Amen. So you're still at a place where you are trying to expand in your vlogging because, you know, again, you know, at one point I was married. And if I was to have known you before and seen all of your work before, I would have been like, I want him to come and take my pictures and I want him to do my, you know, my video vlog of, you know, my whole, you know, getting married and getting prepared and all of that. And so like I said, like quality matters. And
it does.
The Lord wants excellence from us. He wants excellence from us. He doesn't want us to do things halfway or a little bit or, you know, a little good. He wants excellence. He wants He wants good. He wants great. He wants, you know, acceptable. And he wants it because we are of him. He wants it to be excellent because we are of God. We are of God. So everything that comes from us, everything that we put our hands on, that he has graced us to do, he wants us to do it in excellence. And I believe that you are, you work in that vein at all times. So I just, wow. Is there anything that any type of experiences that maybe you want to share, or any advice that you would like to give kingdom men and women, you know, advice on launching out on their businesses, you know, following their dreams, following the dreams and the visions that the Lord has given them, and stepping out of that box and just walking into that next?
I will say, be faithful over what you're doing. If this is your passion, be faithful over it and continue on. And then the Lord will make your name great. The Lord will put your name out there. Your gift will make room for you. That's how I got invited to Texas. My gift made room. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you something, and not to go off into a different subject. Mm-hmm. It's the same subject, though. But like my wife, this how I met my wife. I was watching her YouTube channel. I just found out about her. I came across her, and I was watching her YouTube channel. And I noticed she only had 2 or 3 people watching her videos. And I remember thinking to myself, this is 2015. Mm-hmm. It's 2015. And I remember thinking to myself, I could tell you exactly what I was thinking to myself. I said, wow, she's faithful, because I would have stopped. That's what I said to myself. Uh-huh. I'm look at other videos, 2 views. Look at another video, 3 views. And I would just say to somebody, be faithful over a few things. Mm-hmm. 'Cause I know sometimes you get discouraged if what you're doing, you don't feel it's appreciated. Mm-hmm. But continue on. If this is your passion, if you feel like this is something the Lord called you to do, keep at it. That's what I would say. Keep at it.
Amen. Amen. And I just want to let you listeners and viewers know that he's not only talking to you guys, but he's talking to me as well. So I don't want you to feel like that, you know, we're talking at you, or, you know, but this is also for me as well, you know, because this platform right here, like, I had to literally say, okay, God, I trust you. I trust you. If you want me to do this, I'm going to do it. And it's going to be for your glory. It's not for me to be seen. It's not for any of that, because I can, you know, lay on the couch and watch movies and, you know, read my Bible every once in a while like everybody else. But no, you want more from me, because I want the more of you. And I want deeper, you know, I want to go deeper in your word, and I want to go deeper in you. And so, you know, in order to do that, you have to be obedient. Obedient is greater than sacrifice. So when the Lord told me to do this, I was like, really, God, really? What do you want me to do at this point in my life, in this season of my life? But okay, I trust you. I trust you. And like you said, in the word, it says this. Tron Moses don't say that. He just said this is in the word. Your gift will make room for you. Your gift make room for you. In Habakkuk 2:2, it says, write the vision and make it plain. Write the vision and make it plain. I'm a dreamer. You know, I dream a lot. I see visions. And so when the Lord, you know, gives me a dream, or he gives me a vision of something, I write it down. I write it down. And I'm like, okay, Lord, what are you trying to say to me? You know, a lot of times it's really straight to the point. And it's like, okay, I know I need to do this, or I know I need to do that. But sometimes I have to actually sit down and commune with the Lord and have my Bible and ask the Lord to give me a scripture to tell me what it is that he's trying to communicate with me. And so, you know, you have to write it down so that it can be plain. Like, God is not like this. He doesn't want to confuse us. Like, that's not who he is. Like, he he tells us and he speaks to us in a way that we can understand. And so don't make it all like religious and like deep, because that's not the type of God we serve. Like, he is going to speak to us
that's in right, a way amen. That
we can understand. And so yeah. write the vision, make it plain. That would be,
make you know,
I would tell everyone, just write it, make it plain, and then execute it in excellence. You don't have to have everything, because God is going to provide.
You know what? God will give us the seed, but it's up to you to work the seed. It's up to you to keep on watering the seed, and then God will give you a harvest.
Yes.
But a lot of people, they look at how it's not prospering in time. Because you look over at somebody else, and their thing might be growing faster than yours. The Bible says seed, time, and harvest. Mm-hmm. Somebody else's time is different from your time.
Mm-hmm.
Theirs might grow overnight, but God is working. You going through a process. God is he getting stuff out of you. He working on you while you working on the seed.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what people fail to realize. And because I'm be honest with you, I used to look at other photographers and like compare my stuff to theirs and say, man, why I'm not getting the business they're getting.
Mm-hmm.
And I know a lot of photographers mm-hmm. right now that's getting recognized by Sony. They're getting recognized by Nikon. And I was like, why I'm not getting recognized by none? But you know what? I got my own timing.
Yes.
God, I got my own destiny. Maybe that route ain't the route God is taking me.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe he's taking me somewhere else. I'm going to just work the seed until he give me a harvest.
Yes, God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm going to work the seed until I get the harvest. Amen. It is on its way. Amen, Kimberly. Amen, prophetess. Yes, God. I am going to work the seed until I get the harvest. That is worth saying a few right. more times. I am going to work the seed until I get the harvest. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And the beautiful thing about it is I don't have one seed to work.
Yes.
We're working with a bunch of seeds.
Yes.
Yeah. We're working with a bunch of seeds.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. So I have another question for you. I was
ask as many as you want.
I'm sorry.
I said ask as many as you want.
Okay. So I was watching one of TD Jakes' videos on YouTube, and he was talking about how we need to have four streams of income. And, you know, I know every entrepreneur, like you start at your main business. It's like, okay, well, I'm going to do this. But then how did you start to break off and branch off into the different other things, like, you know, being an author and a minister and, you know, a vlogger and a photographer? Like, how did that work for you? And how many streams of income do you feel like, you know, let's talk husbands and wives. How many streams of income do you feel like together you guys should have?
More than one apiece.
Okay.
More than one apiece. But you know what? I've been, for a long time, I've always had more than one income. Even when I was in the world, I was making money different ways. At one job I had, now I had the job, then I also sold CDs there.
Okay.
How should I say this? I also sold sex toys there.
Okay.
I also blew up pictures there. And I'm not even naming everything. I'm talking about this is all at one time. I made money different ways there. The money I was getting, I was going around collecting money, and it came out to more than my check. So I always been making money more than one way. I had another job where I used to do a lot of overtime there. I would come in on, I was on second shift. I would come in on first shift and sell weed to the whole shift.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm not saying that's right now. I ain't telling nobody to do that. I'm just saying how I always had a mind to try to get money in more than one place.
Right. And let's be real, you was a hustler. Like, you made your money.
Hustler.
That's what you did. Yeah. You made your money. It didn't matter how you got it, but you was getting it. And that is how we're supposed to be in the kingdom. Like, God gives you visions. He gives you ideas. You're supposed to go forth and you're supposed to execute. And, you know, me and a mentor of mine, Prophetess, we were talking the other day, and, you know, we were talking about how, you know, people in the streets, drug dealers, like, they are entrepreneurs. They know how to make money. They're just not doing it for the kingdom. They're doing it for the world.
They're entrepreneurs with a perverted entrepreneurship.
Yes.
That's what I would say. With a perverted entrepreneurship.
Yes.
But they are entrepreneurs, because it's a lot of guys out there that's never coming out of jail, that made millions on the street, but they had so many levels of soldiers under them. You running a corporation.
Yes.
That's a business. But if they would have just did it the right way, they would still be out now, still getting that money.
That's the street pyramid scheme. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you know, and I remember, you know, I had, I have an uncle, and he's been in and out of jail most of his life. And he told me at one point, because I wanted to, he was having over the holiday, you know, all of my family was together. And so, you know, all this Bitcoin and investing and different things, all of this is out. And so, you know, I'm looking into it because I'm trying to, you know, if it's a wave, I'm trying to catch it. You know, if it's a way to, you know, make money and it's legit, like, I want to know about it. So, you know, I hit my cousin to it. And, you know, I'm asking my uncle, you know, how long did it take you? Because he's had $1 million, just like you said, you know, some other people. You know, how long did it take you to make that million? And you were doing it out of the will of God. And he told me about 7 months, 7-8 months. And he was out of the will of God. So just wonder, just imagine if you are in the will of God and you are doing and you are working your dream and your vision that the Lord has given you in the will of God. Just wonder how he would bless that. How he would bless that.
That's right.
You know?
I look at people like, and sometimes we feel like we can't listen to certain people. Now, I ain't talking about music.
Right.
I don't listen to rap music or R&B, but like, if there's a video, let's just say if there's a video interview with Oprah on YouTube, I would watch that video. Because there's a lot that Oprah could teach us.
Mm-hmm.
Oprah's a billionaire.
Mm-hmm.
Oprah's not a millionaire. Oprah's a billionaire.
Yes.
If there's an interview with, let's say, 50 Cent, I might watch it, because he came from nothing too.
Mm-hmm.
I love, and it's a testimony. I don't care if you saved or not. It's a testimony how you got the way you got.
Yes.
And you came from nothing. Oprah definitely came from nothing.
Yes.
She came from nothing. And I love to hear, I'm a testimony person. My book is a testimony.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, on our vlog channel, we got Testimony Tuesday,
mm-hmm.
to share testimonies, and not just me and my wife, other people sharing their testimonies too. We post those too.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a testimony person. I love to hear testimonies. I love to hear how you came from being hungry,
yes,
to being a millionaire, yes, or a billionaire.
Because
there were some people that was, I heard testimonies. It was, matter of fact, you take, what's his name? Tyler Perry, who was living in his car.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Now, I don't care what people say about his character or nothing.
Right.
I'm looking at the fact that he went from his car to being a millionaire.
Yes.
And following his dream, pursuing his dream.
Yes.
Because a lot of people give up along the way.
Mm-hmm.
he didn't give up. I would like to talk to him like, how you got from the car? Because I didn't hear a whole lot about his testimony. Mm-hmm. I'd like to know how you got from the car to doing movies. How in the world that happened?
Well, I tell you what, this is what I got from it. He didn't give up. Just like you said, you know, when you were watching your wife and she had two viewers, she kept pushing. She, you know, she kept on going.
Oh, and I was one of them.
That's love. That's love. So, you know, he just kept pushing. He kept pushing. He, every dime he had, you know, he slept in his car to see that dream manifest. You know, he slept in that car to see that and produce that first movie. He slept in his car so that, you know, the dreams that God had given him would manifest. Because if he had stopped, if he had gotten down and out because of sleeping in his car, and I'm sure that the reason why he was sleeping in his car is so that every dime that he could make could go towards, you know, his plays, you know, and just paying for production and different things like that. But he was persistent in pushing towards the promise of God.
You know what, too? I feel like this guy told me this before. He's very successful. He told me, you gotta invest in yourself.
Yes.
And I believe in that. I believe in that. Now, let me tell you, years ago, I said to this guy, this concerning photography, and I didn't tell him this bragging. I didn't tell him this bragging. But I was telling him about this lens I had. It was a Nikon lens at the time. And I was telling him about it. I was like, I paid $900 for this lens. Mm-hmm. And he said, $900? I wouldn't put that in no lens. Okay, well, that's the difference from my work and your work. Because,
yeah.
See, I'm paying, you got to pay for quality. People want quality. Now, maybe the people in your neighborhood might not want quality, but people out there,
yes,
who I want to do business with, people out there, they want quality.
Uh-huh.
They want quality. They looking at magazines. They looking at different stuff. They want quality. So if you got to put $1,500 in a lens, put $1,500 in a lens. If you got to put $3,000 in a camera, put it in a camera, because you investing in you.
Mm-hmm.
You're not buying that stuff. Nobody, I don't think nobody buying that stuff just to take pictures of their dog and their family.
Right.
You investing in yourself. No matter what you do, what kind of business you start or whatever, you're going to have to make some type of investment in yourself,
mm-hmm,
to get where you see yourself going.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that's the same thing, you know, God, like just go back to the foundation. Like, God invested in us. He gave his only begotten son to die for our sins. He gave his only son. He invested his son in us so that we would be saved. So that we could be saved. So that we could have eternal life. And so, you know, that's the greatest example right there. Like, God is showing you got to give something to get something. You know?
That's right.
You got to give something to get something. So, you know, you have to invest in yourself. And like you said, you know, people out here want quality. It might not be these people next door or down the street,
yeah,
or around the corner, but they want quality. And God has made us, you know, because we are in the kingdom, he has made us people to execute things in excellence and not mediocrity.
That's right.
Not mediocrity.
That's
we are
right.
Not supposed to be mediocre. We are the salt of the earth. We are the Savior.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. Amen.
Amen. Amen. So just, oh, hallelujah. I just thank God for you being on here on today. I just feel...
I thank you for having me. I really do appreciate it.
Amen.
I really do appreciate it.
Amen.
And like I said, for those that wasn't on here, I didn't know why she wanted me. Because I didn't see myself as somebody that, and I'm not trying to do no false humility or nothing like that.
Right.
Because that was my real, when I saw your message, I was sitting late one night with my mother and my sister.
Uh-huh.
And I told them, I told them what I said to you. And they said, why would you say that? Because I really wanted to know why you want me.
Mm-hmm.
For two reasons. One, I'm trying to see what you know about me. And two, I really didn't see me as being somebody that somebody would want to interview, because it's the ministers out there. It's a lot of preachers out there and different people. You know, I felt like those would be the people that you would want to interview. Yeah.
God is he's speaking to me in a totally different way, and I'm being obedient because, you know, he's doing, like I said, he's doing a new thing. And so, you know, I don't think about the pedestal or the platform of the person, because God values each and every one of us. He values each and every one of us. And I friended you on here 2 years ago, and I was looking into you trying to see who you were, because it was like God put that spark in me. You know how like God is like really like it's something about him, like it's something about him. You need to connect with him. And so I didn't know what it was, but I knew I need to know more about this Tron. Like I need to find out who he is. And then, you know, watching, you know, your courting and your engagement of your beautiful wife, and just watching all of that unfold and being able to feel like I'm a part of that, and feel like I know him. Like I feel like I know them. You know, like I feel like we could go on a double date, or, you know, they can invite me over for a barbecue, or, you know, something like that. So, you know, God has given me a gift of being relatable. So I feel like I can, you know, come to your and your wife's house and, you know, have a glass of tea, you know, and sit down and we can chat about, you know, what we have coming up. You know what I'm saying? It don't even have to be all religious or anything like that, but you know, he put it on my heart, and I was obedient, and I reached out to you, and I'm glad that I did, because I am, you know, there's times that I've fallen, and I got back up, and the Lord dusted me off. He said, okay, sin no more, and I'm like, okay, Lord, you know, I'm going to do really hard, you know, I'm going to work really hard to listen into your voice and to walk in the spirit. And when he told me to reach out to you, because I was like, Lord, really, like, you know, I'm still getting into the, you know, I'm still getting into the, I'm like, okay, God, I'm going to do what you asked me to do. I don't know what he's going to say. He might say no, but you know what? At least I'm being obedient. And so I just thank God that you obliged to the invitation. And it's blessed my soul. And I know it's blessed everyone that is watching today. And it's going to bless everyone who will listen when we do the playback on the radio station, Influent Media, influentradio.com. And so I just thank you for accepting the request and coming and just showing and telling us how the Lord worked on you and in you. And I do not take this for granted. I'm humbled. I am humbled that you are here right now. I really, really am. And I
thank you so much.
I thank God for you. And I thank God for your beautiful, beautiful wife. I thank God for your beautiful, beautiful wife. And I would love to have her on as well. And maybe you guys can come back together too. So, you know, and if she's there, you awesome. Can come on and say hi. Don't be shy.
That would be awesome.
Amen. Amen. So again, thank you. And if you don't mind to pray us out, that would be amazing.
Okay. And first, I would like to plug my book again.
Yes, please.
The name of the book is called Who Touched Me? My Journey to Jesus. And I take you from the age of 3 all the way up to me giving my life to the Lord. And I show you in the book from me being homeless, me selling drugs, people looking for me to kill me, me planning to murder myself. And just check out the book. I got a cousin that said to me, she said to me, well, after she read the book, she said, it was like a good movie.
Wow.
It was like a good movie. She said the book made her laugh. It made her cry. It encouraged her. And so I would like to encourage everybody, if you can, get that book or get it for somebody. Get it for somebody that's out there. You know what? I sold, people bought it off Amazon, but I've sold the book hand to hand to people. But people that were not saved, like young guys, mm-hmm. I gave it to them.
Amen.
I gave them the book. You know, they might not have read it that then, because I'm the type of person, like, when I get a book, I may not always read it then,
mm-hmm.
but I plan to read it.
Yeah.
In the right season,
yeah.
I read it. That's why I don't pressure nobody when they get my book, like, did you read it yet? Did you read it? No, mm-hmm. they're going to read it when it's time.
Yes, that's right.
And I want to plug also the vlog channel again, Team Moses Vlogs on YouTube. Subscribe.
Yes.
Father, I thank you, Lord. We give you honor and glory, Father God. Lord, I thank you for this day, Father. I thank you for what you have done, Lord God. I thank you for this interview, Lord. I pray that this interview bless somebody, Father. I pray that somebody be encouraged, Lord. I pray that they be strengthened, Father God. I pray that they're pressed toward the mark for the prize of the high calling in Christ Jesus. Father, I pray that every ear that hear this will be encouraged, Lord God, not to give up, Father God, but to pursue their dream, to pursue their passion, to continue at it, Lord, until you give them an harvest, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. And Father, I pray for this great woman of God. I pray that you bless her in the name of Jesus. From the crown of her head to the soles of her feet, whatever her hands find to do, Lord, I pray that you bless it and use her mightily, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And Father, I give you honor and glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Glory, hallelujah. Well, I just want to, again, thank you and bless you in the name of Jesus and your beautiful wife. And I just thank you so much. And we will definitely talk about getting you both back on here, because I want to see her beautiful face. I know right now she's not ready, and I respect that, because y'all should have saw me before 3 o'clock came. Okay? So... tell her we'll catch
you. Yeah, like right now she in the other room, but I don't think she's ready to get on camera right now. Yeah.
Yeah, she wrote on here. She was like, I'm not ready. So we'll get her on here next time. And I wanna speak to the prophetess as well. So we will we'll be in contact about that. God bless you, and may he keep you. And just bless everything that you put your hands on, and your wife, your beautiful family. So thank you again. Again, my name is Felicia Renee, and this is Tron Moses. And this is A Vintage Love on Influent Media Radio. Everyone have a good evening. Love you all. Bye-bye.